Hello students, today we will learn that how hydraulic brakes works. Okay, hydraulic brakes are commonly used type of brakes in automobiles, cars and mopeds like this. Okay, as well as they have their use in industrial applications also, wherever we want to stop some moving entity by the help of applying large amount of friction. Remember one thing, that hydraulic brakes works on the principle of Pascal's law. Okay, based upon Pascal's law. So first of all, I will tell you that what is Pascal's law. Okay, suppose that there is a closed system. Okay, this is a closed system. Black outline means the closed system. And inside it, there is some fluid. The fluid could be vapor or gas or liquid. Any fluid can be there. Pascal says that in case we apply a pressure P at any point from outside. Okay, this is the outer peripheral surface. Okay. And we are applying pressure P, in that case everywhere the pressure will become P. Okay, this is the Pascal's law. Okay, so how to get a feel of this thing? I am telling you a daily life example. See, you would have observed that in your motorcycle tire, this is a motorcycle wheel which contains a tire and tube. Okay, and it is inflated, means filled with pressurized air. Okay, so you can see that this is the nozzle through which we inflate the tire, means high pressure air is applied over this nozzle. Ultimately it goes inside the tube and high pressure is applied inside this tire tube system. Okay, now when this wheel is resting over surface, say over the road, okay, so actually what happens, that pressure P is applied by that road on that contact patch. Okay, contact patch is that portion of wheel which is in contact of the road. Since the load is actually applied over there, because rest of the surface is free to the atmosphere, only this is the point over where it is resting over the road. So normal reaction will be applied over this point. Okay, suppose due to that normal reaction the pressure applied over here is P. Okay, now in case I ask you a question, that where the maximum pressure exists inside this tire tube system, your answer could be that over this point, because here it is in contact with the road, here it is applied with the normal reaction. Okay, normal reaction due to the weight of this vehicle. Okay, so here the pressure is highest. Okay, now you can do this experiment, that take the pressure gauge and apply over here. Okay, this is the pressure gauge which shows the pressure of this tire tube system. Suppose it is showing P. Okay, now what happens, move this vehicle. Okay, so that this nozzle comes over this point, over this top point. Okay, and apply this pressure gauge over that point. Okay, you will find the pressure is still same. Okay, in case the pressure is maximum over here, in that case it must show higher pressure over this point compared to that of this point. So this proves that actually whatever pressure is applied due to this normal reaction over this point, the same pressure is there everywhere. Nowhere there is less or more pressure. It is like this. And one more proof is that, see, suppose I say that we are applying pressure over here. Okay, and we believe that here pressure is higher compared to that of other places. Okay, so there is a rule that fluid always flows from high pressure to low pressure. So what will happen, in case we believe that here pressure is higher compared to that of here, then fluid will start flowing from high pressure to low pressure. So continuous motion will start occurring inside the system. Continuous motion means what? It means it is against the law of conservation of energy, because it means continuous kinetic energy will be supplied to this fluid for free. So for moving inside, it has to fight with the viscous forces. It means it will start creating energy. That is not possible. Okay, now coming to the topic, that this is the hydraulic brake system. Remember this thing, that this is the principle I am showing. Okay, principle of hydraulic brake. Okay, so how it works, you will be able to understand by this diagram. See, it essentially consists of a master cylinder. You can see this is a master cylinder. This smaller diameter cylinder is the master cylinder, and there is a brake cylinder. Okay, so actually both the master cylinder and the brake cylinder consist of a piston. Okay, this green colored piston is of master cylinder, and this yellow colored piston is of brake cylinder. Okay, between these two pistons, a fluid is filled, that is the brake fluid. Generally it is oil, brake oil. It is called as brake oil. Okay, so it could be filled with air also, but maximum effectiveness will be there in case it is filled with some oil, because in hydraulic brakes we generally used oil as that fluid. In case it is filled with some gas, then it is called as pneumatic brake. Okay, however the principle is same for both the cases. Okay, now you can see this thing, that this fluid is inside a closed system. I am showing you the boundaries. Okay, like this. See, by the help of arrow I am showing, this is the boundary inside which this hydraulic fluid is contained. Okay, so it is a closed system, closed by these two pistons and these two cylinders. Okay, so ultimately this fluid is trapped inside the system. Okay, now this master cylinder is connected to the brake pedal. Okay, this brake pedal can turn about this pivot. Okay, so in case we apply pressure over here, then it will move like this in clockwise direction. It will push this piston of master cylinder. Okay, and this brake cylinder's piston is connected to the brake shoe. Okay, this is a brake shoe which will go and impart frictional force on this rotating wheel. So this is the schematic diagram of hydraulic brake. Okay, now what happens in case we apply some force on this brake pedal? What will happen? You see that force is applied. So due to that application of force, what will happen? Whatever pressure is applied by this master cylinder's piston, the same pressure will be there over all points of this brake fluid, because Pascal's law is applied. Okay, so whatever pressure is applied by this master cylinder's piston, the same pressure will be allwhere. Okay, now what will happen? That in case same pressure is there everywhere, then over this face of piston of brake cylinder, over there also the same pressure is there. Okay, now this is the principle of application of brake. You see, initially this brake shoe is far away from this outer peripheral surface. In case master cylinder is pushed over right hand side direction, the pressure is applied to this brake fluid, so that pressure is actually forcing this piston to move in right hand side direction. Ultimately this brake shoe goes and touches the outer peripheral surface of this wheel, and brakes are applied due to frictional force, because that frictional force will retard the motion of this wheel. Okay, now how much braking action is applied? Let's calculate that. What I told you, that whatever pressure is there applied by this master cylinder's piston, the same pressure is there over here also according to Pascal's law. Okay, it means what? Suppose over here pressure is P1 and over the face of this piston the pressure is P2. Okay, so P1 equals to P2. We know this thing, that pressure is given by what? Force upon area. So suppose the force applied over this piston is F1 and A1 is the area of piston. So F1 by A1, and the force applied over this piston is F2, and A2 is the area of this piston. So P1 equals to P2, it means F1 by A1 equals to F2 by A2. Now, how much force is applied over this piston? So F2 equals to A2 by A1 into F1. Okay, by solving this equation, F2 we will get this much. Okay, now suppose the cross-sectional area, the area of this face of piston is 100 centimeters square. Suppose, okay, and area of this master cylinder piston is 1 centimeter square. Okay, so it means putting A2 equals to 100 and A1 equals to 1, and suppose the force applied over this master cylinder piston is 10 newtons. So what F2 will get? You can see by applying the values over this right hand side of this equation, what we are getting? 1000 newtons. Okay, so 10 newton is converted into 1000 newtons. 1000 newton force will be applied over this outer peripheral surface of the wheel, and brakes are thus applied. Just by the application of 10 newton force, we are getting 1000 newtons of force. Okay, how? By the help of Pascal's law. Okay, so what happens in hydraulic brakes? Generally the master cylinder's pistons area is very smaller as compared to that of brake cylinder's piston's face area. Okay, so bigger this A2 by A1 is, the ratio of this brake cylinder's piston area and this master cylinder's piston area, greater the amount of force will be applied over the brake shoe. Okay, so by this small explanation, hope you would have understood that how the hydraulic brakes work. Thank you.